You have freed His Holiness from his afflicted torment. And now he walks by the old processions on the other side of the dream. The cradle of the grievous miracle. The final relic. The grail of blood and gold that emanated from the forehead of the Father as he silently lamented the moment of his blessed twisting. That first relic is here. At the top of the Ashen Mountain, next to the Turn Throne, where His Holiness was kissed by a miraculous pain. And now, your final communion with the miracle awaits. Only you will be able to know how much of it has seeped into your guilty heart. That swallowed up sins and sinners alike has had no mercy on you either. At the mercy of the miracle you were, and at the mercy of the miracle you remain. You are no longer anything but one more anonymous visage, without a voice, without countenance. Your penitence is over.
Now.
You have freed His Holiness from His afflicted torment. And now He walks by the old processions on the other side of the dream. The cradle of the grievous miracle. The final relic. The grail of blood and gold that emanated from the forehead of the Father as He silently lamented the moment of His blessed twisting. That first relic is here, at the top of the Ashen Mountain, next to the Turn Throne, where His Holiness was kissed by a miraculous pain. And now, your final communion with the miracle awaits. Only you will be able to know how much of it has seeped into your guilty heart. Thus came the moment of final communion with the sword born of guilt. A last sacrifice in order to finish penance and break off with the ungodly will of the grievous miracle. But the plans of the miracle are capricious. Penance never ends, but changes. Hurts and condemns at will. There is no place for the penitent one on the other side of the dream. His place is here among us. He is the new father and the last son of the miracle. Recipient of our prayers.
Thus shall your name be erased under the heavens.